and welcome everybody to today's presentation. It's my pleasure to talk about the TIA certification. Give you a very quick idea on who EPI is. We basically are a global company with 11 offices around the world, operating in the data center industry for over 30 years, and we are providing data center design and facility certification based on TIA 942, as well as data center governance, operations, and maintenance certification based on DCUS and accredited data center and IT training. Now, one of the key reasons why data center operator owners often choose to go for TIA 942 is because the TIA 942 is truly the only complete data center standard addressing all the aspects of a mission-critical data center. Some guidelines in the market often only address electrical and mechanical systems, which are, of course, important, but for a truly mission-critical data center site, one has to also address other aspects like site location, architectural aspects, physical security, of course the electrical mechanical systems, telecom infrastructure, very important nowadays, fire safety, monitoring of the facility, and as Jonathan also indicated, efficiency. So data centers which are certified for the conformity to the TIA 942 therefore really stand out if they have been assessed basically on all the aspects which, you know, could potentially pose a risk on the availability of the data center. TIA understands that not every data center is equal in terms of business criticality. So therefore, the standard has four distinct levels for redundancy planning for the data center design and implementation. Rated 1 represents the lowest availability expectation level, which is basically based on a single path of distribution for the electrical, mechanical, and telecommunication infrastructure. This doesn't mean it's a bad data center, but it's just aimed at non-critical environments. Rated 2 has an improved availability expectation where we have a single distribution part still, but we now will add additional components. So, for example, we add an additional UPS, an additional chiller, air conditioner, etc. So this allows you for some level of equipment maintenance and potentially even some component failure. However, there is still a requirement for maintenance, if you have that, then, or a failure in the distribution path, then you could still experience downtime. Hence, although it is more robust than a rated one, it's still often not good enough for truly mission-critical data centers. So that's where rated 3 and rated 4 are aimed at, which is at those environments where high availability is required. Rated 3 is what is defined as a concurrent maintainable data center. This means that this data center can undergo any form of planned maintenance without causing any impact on the IT. Therefore, this supports, of course, 24/7 business operation. This is achieved by having at least one active path and a standby path, which could be activated during those maintenance situations. Please note that there is still a potential unexpected failure in the component and distribution parts, which could lead to downtime. However, most data center operator owners, they still design well above the rated 3 requirement, where they choose to, for example, implement multiple active paths instead of the minimum requirement of one active and one standby. Although, strictly speaking, it's not required from a certification perspective, it is still a very common practice in the industry. Rated 4 is the highest level of redundancy planning. Rated 4 is what is designed and called a fault-tolerant data center. This means that the data center is able to tolerate a single fault on any component, equipment, or part of the distribution path without causing IT downtime. Now, please note that if you are very unlucky and have multiple faults at a single point of time, then you could still potentially be exposed to downtime. So as such, every organization needs to make sure that they still have appropriate business continuity plans in place. Currently, there are three types of TIA 942 audit and certifications available in the market. The first one is the design document certification. This is often used by those organizations embarking on a new data center design and build project, or where the data center is undergoing some level of redesign or extension. The principle is that the design documents will be validated against the requirements of the TIA 942 standard, If one is appropriate, then a design certificate for conformity will be awarded. After this, the construction phase typically starts. The data center operator and owner can, of course, be confident that if all is implemented as per the design, that the data center facilities will then meet the requirement of the standard. Quite a few data center operator owners make the mistake by trying to save a couple of dollars by skipping this important step, which can create many issues if during the facilities audit, for example, mistakes are identified by the auditor, which could have easily been corrected during the design phase. This could be, you know, in some cases, actually very costly mistakes. So our advice is always skip this important step. The next certification level is the constructed facility certification. As the name indicates, this is applied for the data center facility and is applicable to either data center that have just been constructed, but is also very often applied to data centers which are already in operation. The auditor will now not only just review the data center design, but it will also physically inspect all parts of the data center under scope. The final one, the third option for certification, is the TA942 Ready. This certification is applicable to products such as, for example, modular or prefab data centers, the likes of container-based data centers, data center pods, and even self-contained racks. So the idea is that once a product is TA942 Ready certified, that the customers who are using those products can be assured that once the product is placed in the appropriate environment, that the overall data center setup will meet the requirements of the standard. On this slide here, you'll see some examples of the Aditya, which data center operator owners typically use as a stamp to prove that their data center is meeting the quality and conformance to TA942. There are also, of course, certificates which provides more details such as the rating levels of the various aspects of the data center, as well as things like the issue date and the expiration date of the data center certification and other details. Talking about expiration date, certification for life is obviously not appropriate. That is why TAA is adopting the ISO standard for certification maintenance. Those of you familiar with ISO certification like 9000 or 27001 know that the certification has to be appropriately being maintained in order to guarantee the quality it's representing. So this chart shows you the full cycle where we have the certificate award date. The following year, a surveillance audit will be conducted, which is kind of a subset of the original audit. Year two, another surveillance audit, and then in the third year, we will conduct a recertification audit. The whole aim is, of course, to ensure that any potential changes that have happened to the data center infrastructure, and that could be based on the facility itself, or maybe even loading factors within the data center, that they will not impact the original rating for which the certificate was awarded. This, of course, is very important to make sure that there is a continuous guarantee for quality of the data center and therefore gain the trust of customers actually using this particular data center. So what is the value of certification? Well, there are many reasons, but we list just a few of them. First of all, it allows you to give a clear availability expectation. We all know that customers, and especially our boss, always expect 100% availability. However, as explained, if you have a rated 1 or rated 2 data center, then this is, of course, impossible, and therefore expectations of the customers need to be correctly set and managed. The overall quality is very important aspect of data center certification under TAA, as well as the risk reduction and mitigation management. Getting your data center certified will also help you to manage vendors. Ask yourself, how many data centers have you actually built in your life, and therefore how much risk is there that you might have potentially not understood certain risk factors? Even a simple single breaker or a valve in the wrong position could literally kill your ability to be, for example, concurrence maintainable and meeting the rated 3 requirements. So having an external auditor reviewing your data center and interacting with your vendors will ensure that you have that extra level of guarantee, which helps to make you sleep peaceful at night knowing that everything is in good shape. And finally, of course, trust. Let's face it, as a data center operator owner, we are in the trust business as our customers, whether they are internal or external, place their IT environment in our data center, trusting us that it will meet their availability expectation and that it will be well protected from a safety and security point of view.